In my last video, I created a ROS publisher script to publish a simple hello world string over a ROS topic. In this video, let's take a look at how to make a ROS subscriber in Python to process the data being published. So with our code editor open, let's go ahead and make a new file in our package. I'll go ahead and go down to the dropdown for our sources, package, and scripts folder. And here we can see our current publisher.py, and I'm just going to go ahead and right click and create a new file and call it subscriber.py. Now, to make our development go a little faster, we can go ahead and take some of the things we already implemented in our publisher.py, such as our import statements and our if name equal to main. We do not need to put in a try except statement, since we will not be dealing with ROS interruptions or publisher rates in the script. Instead, we can just put in our function that will create our subscriber. In this case, we will just call it create_subscriber. Now let's go ahead and actually create this function. So def create subscriber. And just as we did in the publisher node, we will have to initialize this subscriber node using the rospy.init node, and then the name of our node, which we will call hello world sub node. Now let's make our subscriber, which we will do by calling the rospy.subscriber. Now, this takes in three main arguments. The name of the topic we will be subscribing to, which in this case will be hello world, as we made in our publisher. Our message type, which is a ROS string, as it was in our publisher. And then the last parameter is the callback function, or in other words, a function that will run every time a new message is received. We will call our function process hello world message. This callback function needs to be created, so we'll go ahead and define it above. Define process hello world message. This function will take in the data that comes in from the publisher, so we're just going to add an input of data. Now, what exactly do we want to do with this data? For the time being, let's just do something simple, such as printing the contents of the message. To do so, we'll just do print, we'll type in message, receive, and we will go ahead and add in the data converted to a string. Okay, with that, our subscriber is done. But something you may have noticed is that if you were to run this script, the subscriber would be created and then the script would end. Since we want this script to keep running until we shut it down, we can use a built-in ROS function called rospy.spin. And I'll go ahead and create it right below our create subscriber function. And this will prevent our script from closing. So with that, we can go ahead and save our file. And okay, that should be everything. Let's try out our subscriber. First, we'll need to make sure we have ROS core running. So let's go ahead and open up a new terminal and type in ROS core. Okay, we have our ROS core running, so I'm going to open a new terminal tab using Ctrl-Shift-T, and we're going to change into our workspaces directory, where our script is located. Here we can see our publisher and subscriber files. So first, we will need to run our publisher, which we'll do with python3 publisher.py, and enter. Okay, our publisher is now running, so let's open up a new terminal window using Ctrl-Alt-T. We'll pull this off to the side. We'll change into our workspace directory again. And this time we will run our subscriber node. Great! We can see that the terminal running our subscriber is indeed printing our hello world messages we are publishing. As always, you can stop our programs by clicking on the corresponding terminal and hitting Ctrl C. So we'll go ahead and stop our subscriber, and we will go ahead and stop our publisher. One thing to note is that we can still run our subscriber script even if our publisher is not running. So if we run it, it'll subscribe to the topic, but since nothing is being published, it'll just keep running until a message is received. So if I go ahead and restart our publisher again, we can see our Hello World messages reappearing on our screen. With that, let's recap. To create our subscriber in Python, we used the rospy.subscriber, which took in the topic name, the message type, and the callback function, which would get executed every time a message is received. We also used the rospy.spin function to keep our scripts from exiting out after creating the subscriber. Hope you liked the video. Be sure to like, subscribe, and check out my online Udemy courses. Link in the description below.